Putin backs North Korea, Russian President slams Trump as leaders clash over Kim. President Vladimir Putin has backed dictator Kim Jong-un over the U.S. as Russia clashes with Donald Trump. The U.S. president wants to slap more sanctions on the Hermit Kingdom and reportedly wants to impose a naval blockade for ships coming in and out of North Korea. But Russian Deputy Foreign Minister Igor Morgulov said today that Putin was not ready to sign up to new sanctions. He warned the superpower would not agree to plans that would strangle North Korea economically. Morgulov was also cited as saying that pressure on North Korea was approaching a red line and could cause it to lash out. Washington has not publicly called for a blockade of North Korea, but has sought tougher UN sanctions, including non-consensual inspections of shipping to North Korea. Stepped-up UN Security Council sanctions imposed in September after North Korea's sixth nuclear test called on states to inspect ships for prohibited cargo. But they crucially need permission from the country the ship is from, and Kim is unlikely to agree. Russian President Vladimir Putin spoke in depth about the North Korean crisis yesterday. He warned that any U.S. strike on the country would have catastrophic consequences. And he angrily slammed Trump for provoking North Korea into a nuclear weapon race. "We believe the two sides should now stop aggravating the situation," he said. U.S. Secretary of State Rex Tillerson is expected to urge allies to back a campaign of even tougher sanctions at a UN Security Council meeting today in New York. North Korea has lashed out at reports the U.S. is seeking a naval blockade. State news agency KCNA said Trump was taking a big step towards nuclear war and seeking the act, and North Korea would take merciless self-defense measures. It would regard a naval blockade as an act of war and a wanton violation of its sovereignty and dignity, the agency cited a foreign ministry spokesman as saying. North Korea tested its most advanced intercontinental ballistic missile on November 29. It boasted that it could reach all of the U.S., in defiance of international pressure and UN sanctions. North Korea justifies its weapons programs as necessary defense against U.S. plans to invade. The U.S., which has 28,500 troops in South Korea,